Goeienaand en welkom, dank dat jullie ingeskakeld het hier bij Klipkop. Weer eens op een zondagavond, 7 uur. Ter oudergewoonte praat ons oor die dagboek van Jan van Riebeeck. En in laasweekse episode was daar oorlog verklaar op die Kaapmans. Ek sien Domina Morgul is in die kletskolom, ek kan nie glo, sy het die episode gemis nie. Maar toe maar, al die aksie is gespaar vir jou. Ons het net by die verklaring uitgekom in laasweekse episode. Vanaand gaan die lood. Daar word lood gegooi. Ek sien Bebop Williams en RJJ is in die kletskolom. Dan kan jy nou ingeskakel het. Ek vat hem vir 'n slag van onderaf boontoe as 'n alternatief. Dan wil ek ook hulle sê aan Mike Simpson. Hallo, maar ek neem aan Finny is ook daar in die agtergrond. Goeienaand Mike en Finny Simpson. Anti Marcus het uit soos altyd gooi vir ons een dab in die kletskolom. En vir RJJ het ek ook een lou gesê, as ook Johan van B, ons bondgenoot uit die Laagland. Bebop Williams. Hallo boys. Ok, ek dink ons spring sommer af met my kamera instel. Waar wil ek wees? Seker hier so. Hy lyk al eindelijk mooi ingestel, maar kom ons hou hom net daar, so side camera, properties, ga van aan een bykie beter, configure video, camera control, autofocus af, en dan stel ons hom so bykie so, daar lyk vir my goed, ek maak hierdie goedkies toe, save asjeblief, ja, maar ek hom net so wat draai. Ons trek nou al hierin, in Mei 1659, dit is, ja, 52, 7 jaar, nadat Jan van Riebeeck hier aangeland, ons trek hulle in die derde volume, ons is al so lang bezig, ek gaan net mooi lig gooi hier so, ek gaan nou lekker bykie soos een spook, maar tenminste gaan die letters kan beter sien. Die hoeveelste dag in Mei 1659, nee, daar word so baie gesê. Ek weet nie eers die precieze dag nie. Dit lyk vir my dis die 19de Mei 1659. Ek sien nie 'n ander datum nie, dis definitief die 19de Mei 1659. Het Jan van Riebeeck homself gesê: "Since we see no other means of securing peace or tranquility with these Cape people, we shall take the first opportunity practicable to attack them with a large force and, if possible, take them by surprise. We shall capture as many cattle and men as we can, but shall avoid as far as is possible all murderous bloodshed. The prisoners we shall keep as hostages, so that we may restrain and bring to submission those who may evade us." Hulle gee nog hulle subnotaakie hier, so: "This resolution amounted to a declaration of war. It was the beginning of the first war between white and black in South Africa." Had ook een mooi gemerk, episode 42. Kom, ek vat net gauw so een swing van my koffie. Sê gauw van my, terwyl ek een swing vat van my koffie, hoeveel mense dink julle gaan in hierdie episode gevang en doodgeskiet word? Want julle kan nou sien, dit is nou declaration of war hierdie. Dan kyk ons wie is die naaste. Ons hou een competitie, as jylle dit so wil kan sien. Ok. Geef my jylle beste raaiskoot. Hier is bitter baie leeswerk vir my. Ek gaan seker later aan het begin sukkel. Dan ek gaan net so afdraai dat hy meer na die ding is. Kijk, daar kan ek sukkel altyd met hierdie. Dan kom ek stel die eerste keer reg op. Wat ek hier later sukkel met nonsens van die kamera wat wil afval in. Is dit nou die beste manier wat ek dit kan doen? Dalk as ek hier die skroewedraaier is en goed hier onder uithaal, gaan dit help. Oeh. Bikkie onstabiel. Bikkie onstabiel. Ons kom nou daarby uit. Ek moes hierdie goed alles voor die tyd opgestel het. Ons het net gesê dis die 19de Mei 1659. This resolution was not even an hour old when news came of the theft of all Brinkman's cattle, at least 30 in number, as well as all his sheep above 70. So the rest of Visagie and Van Rooyen's cattle. Brinkman's comrade Simon Unterveld, after he had fired upon the Hottentots, had been attacked and cruelly murdered with assegais. He had received 7 wounds. In addition, a slave had received a wound. The interpreter De Man, who had been one of the attackers, had picked up Simon's gun and made off with it. He had been pursued by 7 Freeburgers, but is, we fear, unlikely to be overtaken, and there is a danger that our men will also be lost. Orders were therefore immediately given to dispatch the soldiers mentioned to the Freeburgers' houses to help protect them as much as possible from further misfortune and to make all preparations for the preservation of further disasters, since 4 farms are already in complete ruin, brought to a standstill in the midst of the ploughing and sowing season. This is most detrimental to our agriculture. No sooner had this report reached at the fort than all the Hottentots in the vicinity took to flight with women, children and everything else. Jy sien, baie van hulle het dalk nie eers gesien kom nie. En gesien, o hel, die kak gaan nou spat. En hulle het maar net gevlug. Hulle wil in die crossfire gevang word. Wat julle kan sien, hier is nou een ou is doodgemaak met 'n assegaai. Simon Unterveld het 7 wonde opgedoen, assegaai wonde. Mense, gaan hierdie koffie klaarmaak, anders gaan hy my die hele tyd pla. Oké, okay, nou, gaan ons die leeswerk ernstig vat. Waar val julle om? So daar is nou al die eerste ou oorlede en hulle sê, so, 'n slaaf is ook beseer. En dan natuurlik almal, dis nou net Hollanders aan die fort, die rest het allemaal weggehardop. Net Eva het achtergeblij, as ek het die mis het. En natuurlijk Harry wat op die eiland is. Op die 20ste, dark grey skies. All the company's livestock were brought to the fort from the grain field, except most of the sheep, because the sheep shed here cannot take any more, and the company's oxen used for drawing the plough and the wagons, as these are needed to keep the farming operations going. So hulle probeer nog steeds, jy weet, boer. Furthermore, as we see that the Kaapmans cannot be brought round by friendly means, but that, in fact, they threaten to rob us of all our cattle before they will desist, and to kill anyone who even attempts to prevent them. Full permission has been granted to all our people to seize them or shoot them down wherever they can do so. That is, those they can catch anywhere near their houses or happen to encounter elsewhere. Each man must remain at his home to protect his own property until such time as further orders are given for taking the field for this specific purpose. This will be after our scouts who have been sent out return and bring full information where would be the best place to get at the Kaapmans, so as to do them the most harm and once and for all properly to put fear into them. So Jan is nou niks lekker nie. Hy wil hulle nou loop uitvat. Only the interpreter Eva remained in the commander's household, and she appeared to be most dismayed when she saw all the preparations and heard about the plans, for, as she can speak and understand Dutch well, it was difficult to keep anything from her. She said that the Kaapmans who were still at the fort yesterday had tried to entice her away with them, but that she had preferred to remain here. Her only fear was that if any of Udasua's people should come here, they would also be killed. But she was assured that precautions would be taken against any such happening. It was explained to her that we had endured the Kaapmans' insolence quite long enough, and that although as recently as last Sunday, we had tried through her agency to get them to make peace with us, they had spurned our approach and had indeed that very afternoon murdered a free burgher most miserably and had stolen 70 sheep and 40 head of cattle. Apart from previous robberies, who knew something about him? We shall therefore offer all possible resistance and also cause them as much harm as lies in our power, because they have not heeded the voice of friendship. They shall by forceful means make them more reasonable and cooperative. In this just cause, the Lord God would moreover help and support us. So dis sommer 'n goddelike roeping nou. Hulle doen dit in die naam van die Here. In the afternoon, the scouts, who had been sent out, returned with the report that they had not spied anything anywhere, not at the Houtbay, in the Berg Valley, nor in any regions of this cape. Nor during the past 6 to 8 months had there been any encampments or cattle anywhere in the vicinity, judging from the fact that these areas were covered with greenery and had not been trodden underfoot. The Kaapmans must therefore have retreated beyond the mountains of Africa, where they will be no more easily captured than a bird in flight. Hulle sê hier aan die onderkant, dis omtrent daar by die, in die Parelse area, Stellenbosch, weet, ander kant die Cape Flats, ander kant die Cape Flats. In the evening, news was received that the free burgher Jan Reinersen had also had his cattle stolen from right in front of his house. But this was chiefly the result of his own negligence, for he had left them untended while he and his wife were at the fort, there being only his comrade and a servant at home, and the cattle had been left a trifle too long on the other side of the fresh river. Nou, ek het nou weer hierdie kaarte opgetrek. Oef, uit die pad uittrek, gauw hierdie afhaal. Ja, hier is nou natuurlijk die prentjie wat uit die boek het kom. Hierdie is een foto wat ek gekry het van een ander plek af. Nou Jan Reinersen, hulle het so half die, een paar episodes terug, het hulle die grens hierdie rivier gemaakt. Nou Jan Reinersen, waar so is hy? Hy moet hier ergens wees. Jan Reinersen, hier so is sy blokkie. So sy blokkie gaan so half oor die Vars rivier. Hier hardloop die Vars rivier hier deur. So dit lyk my, hulle het, wel het moes eerst die grens hier af. En nou trek hulle terug. Hulle gaan nou sien, hulle gaan vanavond verder terugtrek.
We also received news that today fully 20 Hottentots were seen on the commander's land near the Bosheuvel, which is the furthest point and is about 3.5 hours from the fort. They intend to drive off these animals as well, but had not yet had an opportunity of doing so.
Nou moet net om vir julle 'n bietjie konteks te kry, dit mos nou oorlog, dit gaan nou baie meer sin maak. Ek het dit al 'n paar keer gesê. Nou die Bosheuvel, hier loop die Vars, hierdie Vars rivier is baie belangrik. Hierdie Dit is 'n natuurlike grensiesel, maar die bosheuwel lê aan die ander kant die Varsrivier. So hulle probeer nou nog daar verdedig. Hulle sê hierso van Riebeeck's second farm, dis hier waar hy die klomp wingerd en goed geplant het. So dit lê nog aan die ander kant die Varsrivier. More soldiers were consequently dispatched to the company's grain fields, to the Freeburgers and to the above-mentioned Bosheuvel, so that above all they might protect what each one still had. In addition, all work has been stopped and the foresters have been recalled to guard closely the company's livestock here at the fort, a very fine herd which the Carpens have boasted they will come for in rainy weather. So there's no code red aan die Kaap. Hulle trek so al hulle belangrike goed trek hulle terug. Hulle vorm nou 'n laar. The seven Freeburgers who set out in pursuit of Brinkman's cattle last night were driven back by the band of Hottentots, about 20 in number, who had been responsible for the theft. Out of sheer carelessness, most of these Freeburgers had armed themselves with nothing but pitchforks, only two or three of them carrying firearms. This reverse is thus largely due to their own negligence, which the Hottentots have observed from time to time and have now thoroughly taken advantage of. Dumaan in particular has been urging them on to all these misdeeds. A reward has thus been promised for his person. 100 guilders alive and 50 guilders dead. For others of these common robbers, the reward is to be 20 guilders alive and 10 guilders dead. Women and children at half these sums. To gain these rewards, various free artisans, as well as those freemen who have recently been robbed of their cattle, intend to offer their services or have hereby done so. We shall see if with their assistance we can capture these thieves, especially Dumaan. This will probably cause these robberies to be somewhat checked, and the robbers will be thoroughly frightened. May the Almighty give his blessing to this enterprise. So daarso is 'n prys op Dumaan se kop gesit, as ook enige iemand wat kom moeilikheid soek, vroue en kinders ook. Op die 21ste, hulle sê nog hulle is 'n nuwe maan. Very rainy weather in the morning, stormy and overcast, a special prayer was offered up to God that he would withhold from us the adversity with which he is so solely afflicting us at present, in the serious loss of livestock through disease, as well as the thefts, robberies and murders committed by these barbarous people. To this end, a day of fasting and prayer has been declared for tomorrow. Die ouens is nou nog besig om terug te val. After this prayer, the volunteer Freeburgers being ready and armed to set out against the Hottentots, the Freeburger Jan Reinersen came with the request that he might have his wife brought to the fort, and the Freeburgers of Otto's, Stevens and Harman's parties with all their sheep and cattle, excluding the six drawing their wagon, took refuge in the fort, for they dare not remain at home any longer for fear of having their houses set on fire. The fiscal, fearing similar calamities, proceeded to warn the wife and children of Hendrik Boom and the other Freeburgers to betake themselves in case of a necessity to the stone redou Korenhoop, which was close to their homesteads, or else to go to the fort. The honorable company would keep its plough oxen at the granary, and the commander his oxen at the Bosheuvel to the last, since the Hottentots still covet them ardently. But men have been detailed to be on the lookout for them.
May the Lord God grant them courage and valor so that we may capture some of these scoundrels.
Nou, maar net om weer hulle het nou hier gepraat van die Otto's en die Stevens colonies en trek gou weer die hulle sê nou nie hier precies waar is Otto's en Stevens colony nie. Ek kan nou nie kan Otto en Stevens se name hier sien. Ook nie. Orange Tune. In elk geval, hulle het geplaat van Hendrik Boom, sy plaas nogal belangrik. Sien nie Hendrik Boom en Jan Reinertsen. Hulle plaas is so half een kant, baie nader aan die fort. Nou die, kan julle sien Koornhoop lê tussen hulle plase en die ander plase. Dis nou om die vryburgers te beskerm hier, om al verder hulle afgaan. Hierdie ander manne het allemaal gesê, nee, maar hulle bring hulle goed terug. Sê, want hierdie is nou die naaste kanon aan die fort. As jy hier so sit, Duinhoop is hier so, en Koornhoop is hier so, so jy is redelijk goed gebeskerm. Maar hier dieper in, begin raak het een bykie, jo. Die company's grain fields hier so. Dit moet ook glo onder beskerming van Koornhoop geleed, maar leem een bykie ver van my na my sin. In elk geval, baie lief vir die kaartjes. Kom op wat gewees oor vinnige breukie. Gou hierdie aan. Dan kan ek met my mense gesels. Gou 'n entjie laat. Die lood gaan nou begin spat, moenie worry nie. Die ouwens trek het gewoon 'n bietjie terug. Mm. 24 oor, ek stel uit. Ek praat met Brendan Campbell in die stoort. Kan jylle nou meer? Was achter jou oor in, he? IJs Swart is ook in die kleedskool om. Goeie naand, IJs Swart. Finnie Simpson vraag, dink jylle ons gaan môre kak, he? Het ons nie elke dag kak, nie? Ja, ek sien daar gaan sulke video's om. Ek luister nie na mense wat sê, ja, maar hulle het gehoor by 'n betroubare bron dat XYZ. Ek het al te veel kere gesien dat jy brand jouself. Jy brand jouself. Ek sien die persone XYZ het hulle trans so 'n bietjie verander. Indien nie môre nie, anytime soon, ja, maar fucking dit is. Ons het elke nou en dan het ons KAK so. Daai stelling is vir enige datum waar. Brenton, maak het nou 'n triple X channel. Kijk hoe stoom die spiel op. SMS hot to 35050 to make all your dreams come true. Hier kom echter definitief binnenkort KAK. Ja nee, wat dan, daar kom altyd KAK. Dit gaan nooit stoppie. Dit gaan nooit stoppie. Ja, ek moet bietjie loop kyk na die backstory. Ek het nou, ek sien julle praat van Isak. Is dit nou oom Sakkie waarvan julle praat, van die boerelegioen? Ek het nog eens sy video's loop kyk, dalk moet ek. Partykeer is daar so baie drama, dan loop kyk ek 'n ding, of ek wil 'n ding loop kyk, sien ek ja, maar die video is sommer teruggetrek, jy weet. Dan is ek 'n bietjie laat tot die party. Ek gee nie meer so lekker aandag nie. Kom ek blaas vir julle kringetjies. Ek sal nou aangaan met die boek, moenie worry nie. Hierdie laaste stukkie rook aan so lekker.
Peter Stuyvesant.
Oom Saki. Oom Saki raak oomslaan Saki. Ja, oom Saki stuur vrouwe en kinders in die EFF in. Oeh, drama. Dis 'n fucking soap opera, sosiale media. Soap opera. Hoe meer drama, hoe beter. Wat se kak bedoel julle? Die gebruikelike? Die gewone ou kak, ja. Daar kom altyd kak. Maar daar is mense wat sê daar is 'n besonderse hoeveelheid KAK wat gaan kom môre. Mike Simpson sê hy gaf my dingetjie op Discord plaas. Ek sal op kyk, Mike, moet jy nie worry nie. Ek sal op kyk. Kan nie eers 'n dual stream. Ek weet nie, ek het die probleme nie, maar dan ook weer, ek praat net oor die dagboek van Jan van Riebeeck. Net die diepte wat verskil. Almal het so te kere gegaan oor hierdie Jacob Zuma besigheid wat hulle die winkelsentrums loop afbrand het en so aan. Dit was 'n bietjie erger as gewone riots van ons kant. Dit is amper asof die mense gaan nou te kere, maar dit is nou al vir hoeveel jare is dit so? Dit is 'n bietjie erger as gewoonlik, ja. Maar dit is nog die hele tyd so. Hoekom is julle verbaas? Wat ek tog dink gebeur het is die ANC het so half steun in die buiteland. So stelselmatig beginne verloor. En ek dink hierdie riots en goed was nou so half die koel wat deur die kerk is. Ek dink hulle het nou die morele hoë grond, hulle nou finaal verloor. Ek dink daar is nou tyd vir die oppositie. Dit is nou hulle het nou 'n bietjie meer vryheid. Ek dink die buiteland sal nou hulle sal nou meer gereed wees om te luister na hierdie proteste. Soos homself gedidos en dit as deel van sy martelaars persecution narrative aangewend. Hulle almal maak my siek. Nou, miskien die ou wat die server maintain, die verkeerde setting verander, is ook moontlik. Maar ek sien die mense gaan so te kere oor die DDoS en sovoorts, dit is... Mike Simpson sê, gaan kyk op At The Truth op YouTube, oom Saki het daar gepraat met Scott van Loving Life. Ok. Domina is op 'n ander level. Ja, die, wat is die Willem Petzer se ding? Die tax-revolt besigheid. Hulle is ook gedidos gewees. Gedidos, terwyl jou XML-RPC heel oop is vir die wêreld. Waar wil ek gewees het? Terug by die boek. O ja, waar was ek gewees? Ons het nou klaar gelees van Hendrik Boom en so aan. Ons kom nou... The flight of these unfortunate Freeburgers is most depressing to behold, and it is also a great pity about the rye and wheat, most of which, after daily sowings, is now in the ground. Much has already sprouted green and fine. Each farmer retaining only 6 draft oxen is now disposed to guard his house and to turn his attentions to the Hottentots as much as possible, so that with these 6 oxen and wagon and his wagon,
he may, in case of need, save and any further possessions he may have.
Slawe word losgelaat.
So that the Hottentots may better be overtaken in flight, since they are too nimble for us, it has been decided to release all the slaves from the irons. They are embittered against the Hottentots and would indeed like to wipe them out, so that we may use them against the Hottentots, arming them with half-pikes until such time as they have obtained assegais, which are more effective weapons of offense. At present, over 40 men will have to be stationed at the fort and at the company's granary to keep watch over the cattle and sheep there. These are in addition to the men who have been sent out everywhere to defend the Freeburgers. At present, there are thus only one sergeant and one corporal with two soldiers at the fort standing guard at night. All work has been stopped, for which reason, circumstances being as they are, one wishes that there were a ship at anchor here, so that we might draw some reinforcements from her.
Hoognoot. Nou hier kan jy nou lees van Hendrik Boom, die grote Hendrik Boom.
The Freeburger Hendrik Boom has built himself a fine house on which he expended all his fortune, fully 1,700 or 1,800 guilders, which had accumulated to his credit since in his 6 years' service he had not drawn any of his wages. He is remaining behind with his wife, determined to hold out as long as possible with the assistance of the two company soldiers given to him. It is a plan which is far too audacious. As long as they are able to do so, he is resolved to defend their lives and property rather than flee now to the Rideau Koornhoop. He has five children and many fine cattle, pigs, fowls, etc. To this Rideau, the wives and children of the farmers Jacob Kloeten and Jan Martensen de Wacht have also retreated, leaving the men at home to protect their houses, as said before, to await developments.
So die mense is besig om terug te trek, aan mekaar. Jo, dit is baie leeswerk vanavond, ons wil amper een half uur in.
In the meantime, the fiscal who had been sent out to all the men had given orders inter alia that a sturdier enclosure should be made at the company's granary because there would not be enough pasture for a week of all the cattle in the Table Valley, so that they have to be put out for pasture some distance away. They cannot therefore return to the fort every day, nor can they be kept at the fort except for a few of the oldest, which are no longer fit for breeding, as they are used for the garrison's meat supply.
Nou maar hulle is net, hulle is besig om al die vee ook terug te trek en so voort. Ek dink ek gaan deur alles gaan nie. Hier het ek tog wel geonderstreep.
Preparations have also been made to arm the Batavian convict in order that they may thus earn their freedom, as well as some slaves from whom assegais are being made in their own fashion and under their direction.
So hulle gaan van die slawe vrylaat van Batavia spesifiek en dan van die ons eie slawe, van die seker maar die Kongolese slawe of die Indiese slawe as hulle saam beklei. Nou raak die dinamika van hierdie oorlog redelik moeilik vir enige iemand met een narratief om die Europeërs as evil mense uit te beeld. Ja, maar hier is dan nou die slawe en tot die Afrika slawe, hulle is ook, hulle word ook as 'n gijs gegee, hulle gaan nou saam beklei. Die narratief raak nou baie, baie kompleks. Die mense val verder terug.
Several Freeburgers have been found to be so terrified and overcome with such fear that some of them fled last night to the Rideau Koornhoop, completely deserting their houses and leaving them to the mercy of the Hottentots. Farming is everywhere at a standstill and being neglected, since no one dares go into the fields with his plow or anything else. All the more pity at this time, in the rainy season, for thus 1/6 of the land will lie fallow to our great detriment. Want daar is nou al die grond oor kan die Liesbeek. Hier is nou een resolutie, dit is meer admin wat gebeur. To bring to the company's granary and to be kept safe there, dit is nou al hulle ploe en die type goed. Hulle moet alles nou terugtrek na die grote skuur toe. Hulle praat hier van slow matches, lont en swan wat hulle spaarsamig moet gebruik en so voort. Dit is meer administratieve goed hierdie. Kom ons lees net so hier en daar een stukje waar. The men who had been sent out were first of all to see whether they could simply capture one or more of the Hottentots whom they could compel to show them where the encampments were, so that these might then more easily be found and attacked with greater force. Nou natuurlijk, daar is duidelijk, hulle het geen idee waar hulle op die oomblik is nie. Hulle wil gaan aanval, maar hulle weet nie waar die mense is nie. Nou julle, ek het al baie keer gehoor, ja man, die boere is die mense wat guerrilla warfare uitgedink het. Maar julle kan nou sien, hier so waar vanaf kom guerrilla warfare eindelijk. Prong voor die boere. Boom was to be granted permission to let his cattle graze under the protection of the company's herdsmen, either at the fort or at the granary, whichever he found the more convenient, while he remains at home without budging with his wife, children, possessions and all his livestock. Kring Hendrik Boom, hy staan vas. Hy hou hulle telly van. Pardon, van Visagis Company, ek het hier een stuk misgelees. Daar, allemaal trek terug. Ek sien, die mense is vreesbevangen, en daar is al die dieren wat gesteel is. The Carpens have therefore robbed these four companies of 68 head of cattle, young and old, and 67 sheep. Nou, daar is een ou oorlede ook, en daar is een slaaf gewond. As far as Ruin's company is concerned, his partners are very slack and lazy fellows, although they have so far incurred few debts and will apparently have to be taken back into the company's service. Ek het dit nou maar gaan onderstreep vir, ek weet eers hoekom nie. Kom op parade. Hier so is een stukje, julle kan vir oom sakkie tag. Hier so is nou kom op parade in Mei 1659. This afternoon the commander visited the dwellings of all the free burghers and set in motion the execution of the following orders. Every Sunday afternoon the burghers who live close to the fort, who are called the town burghers, shall come into the fort with their corporal while the... Kom ek probeer weer. Every Sunday afternoon, the burghers who live close to the fort, who are called the town burghers, shall come into the fort with their corporal while the garrison, fully armed, is on parade. After marching round in the fort two or three times, they shall proceed through the gateway of the house of their sergeant or chief officer, where they shall assemble. They shall next present themselves together with all the country burghers at the stone redoubt Koornhoop, where either the commander or some member of the council will always be present, and who, after the service which shall take place there, will review the burgher parade and make an inspection of their guns. He shall have one runner of wine or brandy issued to every man before allowing each one to go back to his own place. The brandy will probably tempt many sluggards who might otherwise have been indifferent and stayed at home, although these arrangements are vital to their own protection. So die mense word letterlik ingeroep, hulle moet in die fort so twee draaie met hulle marseer, hulle moet gaan na hulle sergeant se huis toe en daarvan af moet hulle gaan Koringhoop toe en daar vir hulle reward, beloning. Kry hulle praat hier van 'n runner, ek weet nie hoeveel is 'n runner, seker maar 200 ml brandewyn. Is dit Olofberg of is dit Wellington brandewyn? But as far as the Free Soil, Leonard Cornelissen and his men are concerned, there's no mense wat 'n bietjie verder weg bly. Hulle hoef nie op parade te kom nie, maar hulle gaan geondersoek word. Hulle gewede en so aan. Julle onthou nog dat daar was 'n skip gestuur Sint Helena toe. Want die skip wat die reis moes kom aflaai het vir die burgers vir die fort, het om Sint Helena geskiet. Toe stuur hulle nou hierdie skip agterna om die reis te loop haal. En is nou die hoeveelste keer wat dit al gebeur, maar hierdie skip kom nou terug. Die Zuilen. No more than 2 or 2.5 of the 22 last of rice which has been consigned for the Cape from Batavia in the ships Amersfoort, Phoenix, Walvis and Zeezee, seker die Zuiderzee. The rest of the rice was divided among these ships at St. Helena to augment their provisions for the remainder of their voyage. This leaves us short once more. So dat oorlog uitgebreek en daar's niks om te vreet aan die Kaap nie. Hulle noem ook hierso dat 'n Engelse skepe had put in there, hulle het Engelse skepe geontmoet by St. Helena. Had put in there on 13, 19, 20 and 25 April. So dat 4 Engelse skepe ook daar gestop. Ek weet daar is 'n sekere groepie wat vir almal probeer verduidelik dat ja, maar die Jan van Riebeeck het baie laat gekom. Die Kaap was al 'n metropool gewees. Die mense het almekaar gestop in die Kaap. Die mense het gewoonlik in St. Helena gestop. Dis 'n bullshit narratief daai. Ja, daar was interaksies aan die Kaap gewees. Ja, dis meer as net 2 of 3. Maar dis definitief nie asof die Kaap 'n hustle en 'n bustle was teen die tyd wat Jan van Riebeeck aangekom het. Meeste van die skepe het St. Helena toe gegaan. We sien hierdie skepe het sommer, jy weet, hulle het 'n consignment gehad vir die Kaap en hulle het nie eers gestop nie. Hulle het sommer een keer omgegaan en gesê, ja, maar bokker die mense, ons is nie lus om maar te stop nie. Ons lees nou hier van 'n bosaanval op die 27ste Mei 1659. In the morning the weather was very wet and rainy and the sky was overcast. News came to the fort that the Free Soil Leonard Cornelissen of Zevenhuizen has been attacked in the forest, situated close to the Bosheuvel and fully 3 hours' journey from here, by 50 to 60 Hottentots yesterday, about an hour before dusk. He received only a slight assegai wound in the neck, since his men, armed with guns, had come upon the scene just in time and had put the Hottentots to flight immediately. The Hottentots were so nimble that his men had not captured or wounded any of them, though they did secure 5 assegais which had been aimed at them. We therefore immediately dispatched to him the junior sergeant with 4 soldiers as well as the surveyor, who was to show him how to erect quickly a palisade of planks for his protection. Like the one made at Bosheuvel. With our few men, we can do nothing else but concentrate on protecting ourselves well for the time being. Otherwise, we might have sent someone after the Hottentots to see if any could be overtaken and given a taste of our weapons. But this will have to be postponed until the arrival of the next ships from which further reinforcement can be obtained. Meanwhile, under God's protection, we must take care to guard ourselves as closely as possible against further loss and murder. Want daar is nou 'n ou in die nek gestik met 'n assegai. The party, including the surveyor, returned in the evening and reported that Leonard Cornelissen's wound was a mere scratch, which gave no cause for anxiety. they also told us that about 30 Hottentots had been at the Bosjewel close to the men working on the commander's private farm. After our men had fired on them and some slaves had hauled assegais at them, they had taken to flight and escaped. Leonard Cornelissen was busy making a palisade for his protection in the same way as the commander's men were busy making theirs with planks.
Phew!
Mense, is my keel nou seer gelees. Waar is ek nou? Is my keel nou bitter seer gelees? So julle sien, dat hulle weet nie waar die Kaapman. As ek nou terug, ek hoop ek is terug. Stuyversint. Brendan Campbell sê Domino Margulis knie diep in die Matrix. Digital Domina, there we go. Digital Domina. Ek wag nog steeds vir die Dutch Marines wat Willem beloof het. Mike Simpson sê, hy het die link van Isaac se stream gisterand op Discord ook gesit. Nou maar toe, ek sal hom 'n loer gee. Vanaand lekker op my foon as ek in die bed lê. Voor ek begin 'n balke saag. Nog 'n dodgy data mining site wat hy self gedoen het. Johan van Beer sê, ek glo nie dat ons koninklike marine van daadwerklike betekenis kan wees nie. Of sien ek dit nie reg nie? Nee, ek... Ek twyfel ook sterk dat so iets gaan gebeur. Ek twyfel ook... Wat sê julle van Afghanistan? Hoe mense het ek gelag toe die video's kom van die Taliban op die... op hy perkies wat so in die rondte gaan en met die bumperkaas. Oeh, wat 'n aangesig. Wat 'n aangesig. Mike Simpson sê, hulle verwag weer KAK in Natal, die Kaap en Johannesburg. Ja, dit is ook so half die gist van die story wat ek gekry het. Daar is vir 'n paar weke nou al sprake van 'n koe. Ek byt nog nie lekker op hierdie koe story nie. Ek sê nog steeds die probleem van die groot proteste wat ons gehad het. Dit is, jy weet, dit is nie 'n beplande ding nie. Daar is mense wat aangehits het en so aan, toe hulle die geleentheid gesien het. Maar dit was nie 'n beplande ding, hierdie datum en so aan nie. Hulle het dan nooit advertenties gehad of boggerol nie. Dis die morele vesel van ons samelewing wat net baie swak is. Dit is die morele vesel.
En die leiers, hulle weet, hulle ondersteun sulke goed. Ek meen, ons vernoem paaie na terroriste. Terrorisme word geprys. Terroriste word geprys as helde. En dan gedra die mense hulle so en dan vra hulle hoekom. Natuurlik sal hulle so gedra as Andrew Zondo 'n held is. Bots wagtentjies. Die bots is het botswaantjies. Botswaantjie, hulle noem 'n bumperkar in. Ja, ek praat dan van 'n bumperkar, daar is 'n ordentlike Afrikaanse woord, maar ek meen, ons allemaal praat van 'n bumperkar. Ek het, vandag het ek weer aan 'n mooi alternatiewe Afrikaanse woord gedink. Het julle ook op die tyd verwys na beskuit as guaras? In die koshuis het ons 'n guaras genoem. Ek dink vir my daai is 'n baie beter woord, eg Afrikaanse woord wat beskuit is. Stampkarretjies. Domina Morgul sê vir ons, dis stampkarretjies in Afrikaans. En Uiswart sê vir ons, a jet ski is a waterpony. Daar is nog hulle cool woord. Ek hou van die idee van a waterpony. En Brendan Campbell sê, die perde wat so in die rondom gaan is a rondom talie. Mike Willeko, het julle twee enige vis gevang op Vrouedag? Sê vir my Fini Simpson. Of moes jy maar toe julle die aand by die huis kom, moes julle maar die mieliebom gaar maak vir julle self. Laat vir my weet asseblief of julle vis geëet het of mieliebrood. Jammer man, ek maak nou lelik gat. Ach, dis alles in goeie gees. Alles in goeie gees. Ek dink ek gaan nog so 'n stukkie aankap, nou moet ek het seker maar... Ons is nog iets by Udasua nie. Ja mense, ons is nog bladsye weg van Udasua. Ok, ek gaan duidelik meer moet verkort. Anders te kom ons nooit hier die ding nie. Nou, dis nou maar net hierdie Gabbema, Abraham Gabbema, wat nou 'n raadslid word. Hy was fiskaal in... Jy weet, so'n bykie administratie hier in die Kaap. As jy dalk een afstammeling is van Abraham Gabbema, gaan dit dalk vir jou belangrik wees, maar hier is nog aanvalle. Kom ons lees, op die 28ste, weather still raining and a faint westerly breeze. Now Hottentots were seen anyway. Op die 29ste, lovely weather in the morning, the Freeburger Stephen Jansen came with the news that a band had broken into their sheep pen last night, but finding them on guard had taken to flight. Shortly afterwards, Hendrik Boom arrived to report that a band of 17 Hottentots has also broken into his cattle kraal in the night, that some of them had already begun driving out the animals, but that when he and his servants appeared, they had run away without anyone being able to get a shot at them on account of the darkness of the night. He had found implements of the kind they used for making fires and had come to the conclusion that they had intended to set his house on fire. May God prevent any such disaster, for it would cause irreparable loss to the people, and what is more, most of the grain still lies unthreshed. In the afternoon, a soldier brought in from the fort Bosheuvel with two assegai's wounds in the calf to his leg. It was reported that at about 11 o'clock this morning, approximately 300 to 400 Hottentots had made a raid upon 25 head of cattle and their four herdsmen at the Bosheuvel. After about half an hour's fighting, they had succeeded in making off with 11 of the animals.
Duman had led the band and had thrown 5 assegais at the above-mentioned soldier, but no Hottentots could be hit as they knew how to dodge the firing. They thus got away with the said booty. The result is that farming on the commander's private farm, which lies on the extreme frontier, has become almost impossible. About 25 morgen of land there, sown with good white wheat, and over 1200 vines planted in the vineyard, have now been completely ruined. And the proposed additional planting of so many thousand this season has probably also been prevented by this disaster, as the time for planting is almost upon us. Wel mense, daar is oorlog in die Kaap, en dit lyk vir my asof ons besig is om hierdie oorlog te verloor. Want ons weet nie eers waar die mense is nie. Dit is gorilla oorlog. Behalwe as ek gorilla oorlog verkeerd verstaan, want dit lyk vir my soos gorilla oorlog. Vryburgers word huur soldate. In order that we may better resist the present robberies committed by the Hottentots, it has been decided after due consideration to take into the service of the company at a wage of 10 stivers a day all free burghers who are unable to carry on with farming. In this way we hope to strengthen our position here as much as possible so that we may keep a few parties of men in the field or in ambush. Their services shall be retained no longer than the honorable company's predicament here demands, and this plundering continues. So daar is nou vryburger huur soldate ook. Hy het seker ook gesien, ja, maar hierdie mense, daar is nog geen manier vir hulle om geld in te kry nie. Hy gaan in elk geval vir hulle moet sorg. Gee hulle maar so'n geldie en so aan, dat hulle nou my help die fort beskerm. Dis hoe ek het lees. En julle is meer as welkom om anders te lees. Hulle wil die mense in 'n lokval plaas. Hulle skuif kanonne en goed rond. Hulle sê hierso, 20 of the worst cattle shall be sent out with the above parties ostensibly to graze under the protection of one or two guards so that the Hottentots may be lured to this place where our men shall lie in ambush at night. So hy gaan hulle probeer lok om hulle te vang in hulle dade en dan gaan die skote begin klap. Hulle beplan 'n lokval. Hier word nou admin gedoen, close their accounts. Dis nou mense wat op skepel op wegkruip het en toegevaar het en mense wat oorlede is en so aan. Dit is nou net administrasie hier in die fort. Ons is nou besig om oorlog te praat. Jan Hendriksen of De Nieuwe Nierop. Dirk Corneliusen Groeter of Hoorn. My genade, convict Erdman Gleuge. Hy is mos die ou wat saam in die Hottentots loop bly het en toe van die maatskappy se groente en goed kom steel het. En daar vir die mense daar gegee het en so aan. Wat is story, Erdman Gleuge? Ek onthou nog vir hom baie goed. Drama, op die zuilen, man, dit is nou weer kak en hare. Jy weet die mense, nou, maar die ou drink te veel, of hy vat al die wijn vir hom, en die type goed. Nog admin, hier's administratie, baie administratie gebeur hier so. Julle kan maar daar gaan deurlees vir die mense wat wil. Ok, hier lees ons nou van die lokval. Op die 30ste, fine weather, according to the resolution taken yesterday, a fair-sized body of men was equipped, placed under the command of the sergeant and conducted from the fort by the fiscal Abram Gabbema. They took with them 20 of the worst cattle to graze near the Boshevel and in the region of the Freeburgers on the opposite side. They were ostensibly to be placed under the watch of one or two guards, but the men were to conceal themselves before dawn behind the bushes and undergrowth where the Hottentots normally appear and make their first attack. Die volgende dag, fair good weather in the morning, the commander was out with said 6 soldiers and 4 horses to make a general inspection and to expose a small party in the vicinity of the place where our men were lying in ambush, his purpose being to see whether the Hottentots, when they saw how small his party is, would attack them, since the Hottentots had intimated and boasted that they were on the lookout for him and in belief that they would then be masters of this whole establishment. When the commander's party rounded the mountain, they ran into an obscuring drizzle and the weather became so misty and wet that they soon turned back and put off their enterprise until a better opportunity should offer. Nog 'n bietjie van die Vryburger soldate. On seeing the preparations made to mount guns for their protection in the countryside, the Vryburgers seem to be much encouraged. They are now willing to lend us their oxen and to take the guns to the places determined upon. They have also shown themselves willing to help transport sturdy poles to the proposed permanent kraal at the company's granary for the purpose mentioned above. This is on the promise that they are paid for their trouble, and in these turbulent times we are short of men for such work as well as for other undertakings. En ek is nou al klaar 'n uur besig. Ek dink ek gaan gou. Dis nog 'n belangrike stukkie oor die lokval. En dan gaan ek miskien volgende week verder vat. At about 9 o'clock in the morning, the sergeant, ons kom ons nou lees hier, so dis die 2 Junie al. At about 9 o'clock in the morning, the sergeant returned home with the news that yesterday, towards evening, they had all but surprised 50 to 60 Hottentots who were led by Duman and others. So Duman is definitief besig om hierdie story te lei. Sy naam kom aan mekaar op elke keer as hulle mense sien of wat ook al. They had divided the soldiers into 3 sections, lying in ambush with every prospect of observing them unawares, etc. Unfortunately, through the carelessness of the Vryburger Herman Remagena, their presence was discovered too soon, so that their design was consequently frustrated. Wherefore it had been decided to resume operations the sooner the better, and for this purpose the commander will go out early tomorrow morning as far as the Bosjewel and even further. He shall be accompanied by Stephen Foran, the skipper of the flute Zuilen, and the fiscal with 3 or 4 horses and a few soldiers. Nou maar die mense wat daar kan loop deurlees. Wil loop deurlees, jylle kan maar verder haal loop deurlees. Ek gaan miskien net hier en daar touch. They will be sent out secretly towards nightfall to the Bosjewel, where 20 of the company's worst cattle graze under the care of 5 herdsmen as a decoy. In this way they hope to mislead the Hottentots by some means or the other, and if possible to deal them a hard blow, since with our present small force nothing can be done to them in any other way. It has also been decided to add 4 nimble slaves armed with assegais to the above soldiers to overtake some of the Hottentots in flight, so that some of them can be captured alive. Daar is nou die mense wat so besluit het. En dis nou, ek het nou net 1 maand gedoen hierso, maar dit is nou maar hoe dit gaan wees. Ons het nog eers by die Udasua alliantie uitgekom. Ja mense, daar is 'n alliantie met Udasua gesluit. Maar ons gaan nou eers volgende week daaroor praat. Want my keel is nou seer. En ons is nou state of emergency. Ons is besig om oorlog te voer en dis duidelik ons is besig om hierdie oorlog te verloor. Die mense val terug. Daar is al mense gesterf aan ons kant. Daar is mense gewond aan ons kant al. En daar is probeerslae gemaak, maar ons weet nie eers waar die ouens uitgekamp is nie. Nog so 'n laaste entjie, kan ons praat oor nonsens.
Dan kan ons volgende week praat oor die alliantie met Udasua. Hoopelik kan Udasua ons help. Ek het nog eers verder gelees. Ek het net vir vanaand gelees die actual alliantie wat gebeur. En dis waar ek geëindig het. So ons gaan miskien na volgende week oor die alliantie. En miskien kom help Udasua se mense ons om die Kaapmans te verslaan. Ek weet nie wat gaan gebeur. Een hinderlaag. My genade, ambush, een hinderlaag. Hinderlaag is eintlik 'n baie beter woord. Jy sien, Johan van B. leer sy Afrikaans deur woordeboeke. Die gemiddelde Afrikaner praat nie eintlik van 'n hinderlaag nie. Maar dit is die beter woord. Korrek. Korrek. Maar mense, as dit is, gaan ek vir julle so twee kringetjies blaas. En dan gaan ek vir julle sê, baie dankie dat julle ingeskakel het. Onthou, daar is absoluut geen skaamte daarin, om jou kop uit jou gat te trek. En staan op vir daardie mense wat vir jou opstaan, en dus altyd volhard in. Hou koers.